Hey guys, so this video is going to cover how to write a fraction as a decimal. So I'm going to be going over three different examples. The first example we're going to be working on looks like 19 over 8. So 19 eighths. And we want to take this fraction and we want to change it into a decimal. Now there's one rule, there's one step that we need to keep in mind when it comes to changing a fraction to a decimal, and that step is to divide. So what we need to keep in mind is that a fraction, yes, it's a fraction. We have 19 over 8, but that fraction bar there actually means to divide. So even though this is 19 eighths, this is also 19 divided by 8. And that division is what's going to give us our decimal. Now, an easy way to do this is by using your calculator. If you are allowed to have a calculator, you can go ahead and input 19 and divide it by 8. And here we would get a 2.375 if we just inputted that into the calculator. But some places don't allow you to use a calculator, so I'm going to go ahead and show this the longhand version on how to do that. The first thing that I would do is rewrite this. So I would take 19 and we're going to be dividing that by 8. Well, 8 goes into 19 two times. 2 times 8 gives us a 16, so that when I subtract this here, I'm going to get a 3. Now, we want to get a decimal, which means we need to keep dividing until we get a 0 as a remainder. Now, since I don't have any numbers left over here to drop down, that doesn't mean that we can't continue. That means that we're going to create our numbers. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a decimal to the right of that 9, and we're going to add a 0. Now, if we're going to add a decimal to the right of that 9, that means that that decimal point is going to have to go up in our problem. And then we can go ahead and drop that 0 down. And now we can divide 8 into 30. So 8 goes into 30 3 times, since 8 times a 3 is a 24. And we are going to get a 6 when we subtract that. So what we're going to do is we're going to add another 0 and we're going to drop that down. And now we're dividing 8 into 60. So 8 goes into 60 7 times. 8 times 7 gives us a 56. And I think I'm running out of room over here down at the bottom. But when we do that subtraction, we get a 4. I'm going to try and curve this a little bit here. Which means we need to add another 0 and drop that on down so we can continue to divide. So remember, we gotta keep continuing to divide until we get a 0 as our remainder. So 8 goes into 40 5 times, and 5 times 8 is a 40. So when we get a 0 as a remainder there, that means we are done. That means our decimal is the 2.375. So again, the easier way to do that is to use a calculator. But again, some places, some schools, some teachers don't allow you to have a calculator. So you do need to keep in mind how to do it the longhand version just in case. But if you are allowed a calculator, it's as simple as plugging it in, 19 divided by 8, and your calculator should give you the decimal for it. So let's go ahead and practice another one of those, doing it by hand. So our next fraction is going to be 2/3. This is a very common fraction, and you might already know the value of this. Just because it is a very common value, you've probably seen it before. But just in case you haven't, we just got to keep in mind once again that our one rule for this is to divide. So our numerator divided by our denominator. So that means we're going to have a 2, and we're going to be dividing it by a 3. So it's always the numerator divided by the denominator. So that means we're going to be taking 3 and dividing it into 2, but that presents us with a problem because 3 does not go into 2. So again, that does not mean that we can't continue, that we can't do this problem. All that simply means is that we're going to have to add a decimal point and we're going to have to add a 0. 2 is the same thing as 2.0, 2.00, 2.000, and so on. We can continue to add zeros to the right of that number, and it's not going to make a difference to the value of it. So we're going to add that decimal point and add a zero, which also means that we need to take that decimal point and bring it up in our answer, and we're going to be adding that zero so that now we're going to be taking 3 and dividing it into 20. Now 3 goes into 26 times. That gives us an 18 that we're going to subtract, getting a remainder of a 2. So we need to keep going here. We continue to divide until we get a 0 as a remainder. So I'm going to add another 0 and drop that down. 3 goes into 26 times. 6 times 3 gives us an 18 that we're going to subtract away. And we get another 2. So let's add another 0 and drop that down. And we're going to divide 3 into 20 once again, which we're going to get a 6. So hopefully maybe you're noticing a trend here. We're going to continue to get that 2 as our remainder. And when we drop down, we're going to get a 20 every time. This is going to continue to go on and on and on forever. So this is called a repeating decimal. And instead of just putting, 0.666666666 ongoing forever, there is a shorthand version of that. And that is just writing the 6, the part that repeats, putting a bar on top of it. So just a straight line over the part of the decimal that repeats signifies that that's going to go on forever. So in this particular example, the 6 goes on and on forever. So we're going to put a bar over that 6, and that implies that that's going to continue on, that it's not just a 0.6, that it's a 0.66666 and so forth. So let's do one more example here. Let's do the fraction 7/11 there. So we need to divide this out, numerator divided by denominator. So we're going to be taking 7 and we're going to be dividing that by 11, starting with dividing 11 into 7. Now 11 does not go into 7, so here we're going to have to add a decimal point and a 0, which means we're going to bring that decimal point up in our answer so that we can divide 11 into 70. 11 goes into 70 6 times. That gives us a 66 that we subtract away, which means we're going to get a 4 as our remainder. So let's add another 0 and drop that down. 11 goes into 40 3 times. That gives us a 33 that we subtract. And here we would get a 7 as our remainder, which means we need to keep adding a 0 because we've got to keep going here. And now we're going to divide 11 into 70. 11 goes into 70 6 times. That's going to give us a 66 that we subtract away. And we get a 4 as our remainder. Adding another 0 and dropping that down. 11 goes into 40 3 times. And at this point, maybe hopefully we can notice here that we're going to continue to get the same combination here. We're going to continue to get a 6, 3, 6, 3, 6, 3, 6, 3 ongoing. So very similar to the example we had before where it was a repeating decimal. So the way that we would write our answer here is we would have a 0.63 with a bar over the 6.3 because that is the part that is repeating. So we need to make sure that bar goes over the 6 and the 3, not just the 6, not just the 3. It's the 6.3 that's going to continue to repeat. So our final answer is going to be that 0.63 with the bar over the 6.3.